Feeling good?
Yeah.
What do you eat? You know it's quiet.
What?
Do it before you jump in?
Yeah. It's a warm up, don't it?
Warm up? What are you talking to?
Come on then.
Are you feeling good, kiddo?
Yeah, feeling good, yeah.
Chief support on March the 2nd. Hopefully you're going to avenge your only defeat, mate.
Yeah, defo.
How's preparation been going?
It's been good. It's followed on straight from the last camp, so I'm still as fit as I was in the last fight, but I've gained a bit more again, so.
Do you think you gained from that as well? Because getting there with Tom, you probably was a slight underdog in that fight.
I was only underdog in the town, weren't I?
But, I think there's a lot of people I spoke to all felt that, you know, Tom's, because, he boxed for England. I know you got to the semi-finals of the elites in your final year as an amateur, but he boxed for England and won the Northwest, the Cheshire
and East side in Cheshire,
On numerous occasions. So, realistically, perhaps, technically, they felt he was the better boxer.
Yeah, well, showed on the night, didn't he?
Well, definitely did, mate.
That might have been a down part for him, everyone bigging him up to win, and I was just working away in the shadows, just keeping my head down and worked on the night. So.
Yeah, well, like you say, it paid off, mate.
Yeah.
I came down, was it yesterday, to visit your dad's gym?
Yeah.
Cracky little place you got down there, didn't it?
The video being put up today is boss, give it a watch, it's good, like.
And a lot warmer than this place today.
Oh yeah, it's absolutely Baltic in here today.
So yeah, it keeps you on your toes then,
doesn't
it, mate?
You've got to keep you bouncing, keep you warm.
But why did you pick Rob then to train him? Because your dad, he brought you through the amateurs?
Yeah, he's brought me through and he's always said you shouldn't go with your amateur coach because if you can't, you're not going to learn. If they haven't taught you that from by the time you're 18, how much more can they teach you?
Mm-hmm.
So, and then I knew Tom Karras used to box with Rob. I used to spar him when he was in the AM. So I just
Tom fought Tom Farrell not long ago, didn't he, at the Echo?
Yeah, I think that was his last fight he had.
Right.
So I just got onto him on Facebook and come down. That was about 4 years ago. And then I ended up buying a house. And then I come back after it all settled into my house. And that was 2 years ago. So.
Well, see, you don't do anything the easy way, though, do you?
No.
Mate? You still work full time.
Yeah.
You still help out at your dad's gym as well?
Yeah. After the training here, I go home and help out in the gym.
So you don't do anything easy, but obviously if you've come through this fight, which is a big fight for you, it's certainly not a given fight because we all know Jordan Ellison, he's just turned over and mashed a dog.
Yeah, if he turns
champion up,
he'll give you that hard night, won't he?
Definitely. And like you say, he's already took you out, so he's, I suppose he's feeling very confident when he's in the return match.
I feel more confident than I think he will be because the fighter I was when he beat me and the fighter I am now.
Different?
Yeah, about four levels up, I reckon.
Yeah.
So.
And you've got 8 rounds this time?
Yeah, hopefully.
Do you think you went into that fight the first time with him? Because you were confident, you were 4-0.
Yeah, it was engrossing.
It was a big step up.
Watching stuff like when he got stopped by Zelfa and all that, that was a fight before mine, I think.
Yeah.
I think he boxed Zelfa and then boxed himself.
Well, he got stopped twice on the truck.
Yeah,
in my head,
I might have been in my head thinking I could knock him out, and obviously it didn't go that way, and I was fucked.
But also, I think you had such a good second round against him.
Maybe I think I was just going to try and carry on, but he snuck a shot, didn't he? And
but it's an exciting fight.
Yeah,
it's chief support to, hopefully, Steve Brogan's going to be defending his central area title.
Yeah.
Which is, I suppose, if you come through this fight, and I know we can't overlook, as we just said, can't overlook Jordan Gill, but that's definitely going to be a fight you're going to be interested in.
Yeah, definitely. I want a title by end of summer, at least. And then maybe something bigger by Christmas. I want to move fast, like.
Yeah. Right. Hold on over there.
Yeah.
Nick?
The little pit bull.
The pit bull.
You sparred much with him before?
What'd you say?
Have you sparred much with Cole before?
Yeah, just one spar, 6-rounder.
Yeah?
Yeah, it was good, yeah.
And you're fighting on the same night, aren't you?
Yeah, same night at Greenbank, 2nd of March.
Yeah? Mm. It's Adol Caesar. Cameroon kid.
Yeah. I haven't seen much of him, like, but see him on the night.
Right, well, I hope you both work well and prepare one another well for March 2nd.
Yeah, definitely.
Take care, Nick. See you later, mate. Bye.
It's in Bulgaria. Nice in the summer, eh?
Steve, guess who Steve's with now? Fucking Jordan Belfort.
I know that name.
What's the boss?
I don't want to say what it is. Might be a kissogram or something like that.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to do hairdressing.
Yeah.
With his wig.
We missed it.
Ooh.